Oh, thank you so much for answering those questions for us, Joey. Again, Joey Avalos, guitarist for Stars Go Dim. And also with us today has been Michael Wittig, the bass player for Stars Go Dim. It's unfortunate that Chris and Lester couldn't be with us. Lester is a man of few words, as I've seen on YouTube, though.
Yeah, he doesn't talk much, and when he does, we usually don't want to hear it, though.
He just beatboxes his way through it, huh?
Exactly. He has that Kansas City brother love.
Anything you'd like to say to all your fans who listen to Fame Games?
I just would like to say thank you. With all gratitude and all seriousness, we appreciate you guys tuning in, listening, supporting us. Hopefully we can make it out there someday, and just keep on tuning in. We've got a new album coming out, like Michael said, and we're really excited about it. And we'll check back with you guys soon.
Are you guys planning on doing any European tours?
You know what? That's always in the plans, but is it solid? No. But hopefully sooner than later.
Absolutely. Well, you'll be getting your first invite from us very, very, very soon. We'd like to get a Fame Games Festival going where you guys are headlining for sure. Again, from our Fame Games Hall of Fame, Stars Go Dim here with two Track of the Month wins with the songs Incredible and Get Over It. Check out their music at famegamesradio.com or, of course, starsgodim.com. Thank you so much, Joey.
Oh, thank you very much. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Michael.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you. You guys take care and keep spreading the word about Fame Games for us, yeah?
We definitely will, and just email us anytime. You guys feel free to reach out to Joey and I or Chris or anytime you guys want.
One last question before you go, Michael. We didn't get a chance to ask you, what is your favorite curse word?
My favorite curse word?
Yeah.
I'm not supposed to curse. I got kids. I get in trouble, but I still do all the time.
What word have you dropped too often that the kids pick up?
S-H-I-T.
Yes.
I say it too much. Every time I drop something or just get frustrated, I say it, and my kids are around, so I need to stop.
And they'll go, don't worry, I don't mind saying it.
I try not to, you know, I try to be a good influence on my kids, and so I try not to, but it still slips out.
But I like what Frank Zappa said when he was alive. He said, look, words never killed anybody. Guns do.
Yeah, so when are we going to come out to Spain? When are you guys going to put on a big concert out there?
Very, very soon, and you'll be first to know, for sure.
I played in Spain before, a long time ago, in another band. We played out in Madrid.
Really? How long ago was that?
Oh, it would have been a good 8 years ago. Like that.
The world's best coffee resides here. We just got back from Las Vegas and New York. We were there for radio seminars and conventions. Oh my God, the coffee in America. What's happened?
I don't drink it. I stay away.
Wow. It's a good drug.
I don't drink it.
It's my drug of choice, actually.
I drink lots of pop.
Pop. Now, there's a word I haven't heard for a while, because I grew up in South Dakota. Don't even ask how I landed in Spain, but it happened.
So, you're not from Spain, then. You're from South Dakota.
I'm from South Dakota. I grew up milking cows and plowing fields.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the way, you know, that all the girls should be raised, you know?
I was originally from Riverside, California, which is about an hour south of L.A., and then moved to Hayes, Kansas.
And what did you think of the country girls out in Kansas?
You know what? For the first year, I was in such depression from the move that I didn't see anything. Oh. It was a drastic change. You know, once I got accustomed to it and started playing music again, I kind of started meeting some people, but it was a pretty drastic move.
What
did you think of Spain?
I love Spain. It's very strange because I was first in Japan playing with a couple of bands out there and singing and playing keyboards. And then I went to Liverpool, the home of the Beatles, and got my music education there. And then met Paul Sadkowski, who was living in Spain and produced my first album. And once I landed in Spain, it's like everywhere, there wasn't anywhere else for me to go. It felt like home. There's a lot of freedom here. It's a real great artistic community. I think living on the Mediterranean is a very special place.
Awesome.
Kind of where I found home. But I think you guys, when you do come over, you'll find it charming as well. It's a great place to write and record your stuff because you have a sense of freedom that maybe you see things differently.
That's awesome. What kind of music do you do?
I'm yourself? Kind of into pop rock and R&B mix, a little bit like, I suppose, a Pink would be, but you know, it changes. It's always evolving as you grow up and see the world in different ways. I'm hoping to get my second album done soon, but this radio show has kind of taken over my life. You know, I'm trying to champion the independent artists getting on commercial radio, so that's taking up a lot of my time.
Nice. We'll have to do some shows together sometime, either if we come out to Spain or you make it out here to the U.S.
I'm hoping to get down to
album mix a little bit.
I'm hoping to get down to Tulsa, Oklahoma, and get one of your radio stations there to be airing the show. And, and you guys should be headlining the whole movement for sure, because you're evidence to me of why radio stations in their home markets should be supporting local acts and helping them make it big time, you know?
There's some good stations here. The Edge, the 104.5, they've definitely been very supportive, but also lately Mix 96, the actual hot AC station here, has had us in for the morning show more than once, and the DJ over there, the morning show DJ on Mix 96, she's actually in a band, and her band's going to be opening for us in May, so that should also help us kind of build the relationship with that radio station.
And what is her name again?
Her name is Nina Valente.
Nina Valente, oh, sounds like a perfect person for me to start banging the door down on.
With Mix 96, yeah, her band's opening up for Star Go Down next month, and they've been real supportive of us over there as well.
All right, well, hopefully they'll support the show as well and help us make sure that you guys become worldwide international rock stars. That's the whole idea.
Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.
We like that. And I'm gonna reach out to Tony, holler at him, let him know he's gonna get an email from Stars Go Down.
All right, brilliant. You guys take care, and we'll speak again real soon.
Okay, have a great day.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
That you love.